Ladies and gentlemen, good morning. Thanks for tuning in today. We are talking about all things Splitgate, okay? Yup. Talked about streamers, we've talked about the future. Now let's talk about the competitive scene.
Even the best sometimes, it's a millisecond of a mind lapse where we're getting one tiny aspect of the play.
Kuba with a triple kill, that was insane.
Check this out. So this is my point of view, spectating a free-for-all game in Splitgate in private matches. They have a free cam version, and this seems like so like amazing to me, but this is like bare necessities, right? This is like normal things for a competitive shooter. Like, they have a free cam that a producer or a caster, if you're doing it grassroots, can fly around the map and spectate the game going on. Okay, you can see it right here. You can see I'm flying around the map looking at the game. I can see the players kind of like shadows through walls, so I can see where everybody is. I can set myself up at the very top and look down, but then also all I do, you can see it, I just click on Haylight's name and then I'm looking at their POV. The best part is there's this overlay that shows, okay, Haylight has 21 kills, 13 deaths. Fake Smiles has 12 kills, 14 deaths. Like, all of our data is right there in front of us. It makes my caster job so easy. It's like the simplest thing, and a lot of other multiplayer games have this, but this is what will hopefully help the competitive scene for this game. Producing a tournament is simple. Private match, all you have to do is you go into their private match section of their UI when you open up the game. You type in the name of your private match. You either make it public, which means anybody can join, or you just make it private and it's password protected. And let's just say we call the server Grandmaster Goach. 10 people can join. It's going to be a 5-on-5. And all you do is you go into the private match section where you look through all the servers of people hosting private matches. You look for Grandmaster Goach and you type in the password 1234 and you can get into the game. That's it. It's simple. Nobody else can randomly join unless they have the password or you give it to them and you're an idiot. 10 people max, 4 spectators that are all able to control the viewpoints, and you can swap between people's different people's viewpoints really easily. You don't have, you know, if you're waiting too long for people to join the server because they can't get in or they can't get an invite or blah, 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 and then the lobby bugs out and it doesn't work. I'm specifically referring to Warzone here. It's perfect for the competitive scene. It's simple. Tournament scene, let's talk about that first. This is my bread and butter. Maybe you run some buy-in tournaments. You do pool play. You have... maybe it's 50 players all playing and you're in squads of 5. You have 10 different teams. Let's just do this for ease of numbers. Let's do it. Say it's 4v4s doing private matches, like a squad, just like Warzone. And you do 4 times 16 teams. You put them in a bracket just like any other tournament. You run a 16 team bracket where they run private matches. Maybe it's best 2 out of 3. And you run a certain type of game mode on there. It's very simple. You can run 1,000 different game modes. You could do a gunfight tournament. You could just do a TDM tournament. You could do the, they have like a kill confirmed type game mode. Like if Call of Duty, you know how you pick somebody's tags up for that. Well, in this game mode, you teabag them to confirm them. It's incredible. They have a teabag, you know, counter as well. Like how many times you've teabagged in game. It's great. Regardless, there's that game mode. Like there's a lot of game modes you could do tournaments for, and you could have a variety of tournaments. All of those are super viable and super easy to put on, whether by Splitgate, whether by a sponsor, or whether it's a grassroots, hey, your team pays $20 to play in our tournament, and all of that money goes to a prize pool. All of these things are simple. The competitive scene is another concept, because when you talk about the competitive scene for Warzone, you're talking about the tournament scene. Well, in this game, the competitive scene and the tournament scene are very different. Tournament scene is one thing and fun, easy, simple. The competitive scene could be totally different. We're now talking about a game that could theoretically replicate an Overwatch League. Any esports game out there, Overwatch League, CDL, blah, 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 blah. There's 1,000 different ways to do this, but you could have orgs running specific teams and being put into a season. Look, there's 1,000 different options, and this game falls within the FPS multiplayer 4v4, 5v5, etc. that we've seen over the last decade of esports. And that is easily replicable in this game because of the way they set up their game, the way they set up their spectating client, the way they set up their private matches. All of it is just saying, hey, this game is primed and ready for an esports scene. The problem is going to be funding and eyes and how long this game will actually stay within the FPS meta.